Now, Jim is here from the newsroom. We're going to ask you about the Yankees. Did they have a fight over there tonight?
Yeah, it was a brawl.
A brawl.
What are the...
What, they think they were playing hockey?
Well, it turns... It's a lot like that. It's, they had
isn't
a fight
that,
in
isn't the second time?
Out.
Didn't we just have that in basketball?
Yeah. Yeah, with the Knicks.
Yeah.
With the Knicks.
So
and
now
the,
we have with the Yankees.
Yeah, one of the Orioles pitchers threw at the Yankees' Tino Martinez.
Remember the, old joke? I went to a boxing match and a hockey game broke out?
Yeah, it's kind of like that.
Yeah. It's unbelievable, isn't it, how we are fighting our way through all of these events anymore.
Yeah, I mean, it used to be just in hockey, and now it's like every sport. I mean, you see this in basketball, you see it in baseball, every sport is just turning violent.
What's the point of it now?
I don't know. It's really, I think just people have very high tensions.
Yeah.
And, you know, the tensions of it. It's just, you know, very, very high for some reason. I guess with the big contracts and everything, things are just not the way they used to be.
No. Well, nothing's the way it was.
No.
Even your clothes. Look at the way you're dressed now.
Well, of course, nobody can see me right now.
Well, then I won't describe it. No, but you do a good job. I mean, you sit here all night and you make sure the news watch never stops, right?
Yes.
What the hell does that mean? What does it mean the news watch never stops? What does it mean? It means that there always is going to be something?
There will always be something.
These phrases they use on radio, like the first of 10 in a row, like some mental midget is actually sitting there counting. Saying they only played 9, you know.
Yeah, but
you know what? Does someone actually do this?
They can't just come on and say there's no news.
Well, they should say nothing. Just do it and get off. But I guess that's life is filled with Phil, isn't it?
And people want to be informed,
and they want Hamburger Helper. They like it. They put Hamburger Helper in everything, and that's just part of it. But see, when you get a little bit more sophisticated, maybe you're older or something, when you get a little something, substance, when you get changed, you don't do those things anymore. Those are just, you don't stay long with them if you do them.
Hmm.
Or at least I don't anymore.
Right.
And then there are those who don't even bother with it at all. I mean, I have some friends who don't watch television at all. And I like TV for some things, but they don't even watch it for a moment. Because there's nothing, it has nothing for them. 100 channels and they don't see anything for them at all.
I mean, there's only, as far as I'm concerned, there's only about 3 shows on television that are worth watching.
And on radio, I don't sit and just leave the thing on. Do you leave it on? Just leave it on?
Well, sometimes.
Well, you do for your job.
Like music.
Your job.
Well, I mean, but when I'm at home, I don't listen to
you're not listening
winds,
to Winds, are you?
I mean, I'm like everybody else, just listening to music or listening
I can't
to,
understand yeah. anybody listening to Winds. It just it.
I
when
can't
I get in
either.
The cabin, I
can't either.
Thing,
I don't know how anybody could listen to it.
I can't. You know, and I'm not trashing the station necessarily. I just don't get. I don't get it. I don't get why
it's
anybody
okay.
would get in a car and turn that thing on, and hear no. these stories
and
one
hear
after
the, same
the other
stories over and over.
Yeah,
and over
that's
again.
What I mean. It's like, what are they like hit stories? Is it like, if they had music, would it be like records? Maybe if they did the news in rap. Some station ought to do that.
That would be interesting.
Yeah.
That's why I didn't really like it when I worked over there, because they were just so serious. They were so serious about everything and so insane about covering stories that I was just...
Yeah,
that's
their whole lives.
Off about. I mean, news is news, but they go to the point where it's just, it's insane, where it's...
I've been here 2.5 years, and there's only been 5 stories since I've been here that I really would care about.
Right.
And you know what they are. They're all the big ones, like the Princess Di and Mother Teresa dying.
Right.
The TWA crash. I mean, there's about 5 of them, 5 or 6 of them. When Dole was in running for office, I liked that because we had him on the phone from a diner in Jersey. That I like that. But I really don't, I'm not interested in the news. I don't really live my life according to everybody else's, that's why.
Right.
I mean, I know of it. Sometimes, like, I overheard the Yankees thing. I just overheard that. I didn't hear much of it. I know that when I go to the bathroom here on the hour, there's a newscast on. And right. that's where I get my news.
Well, I mean, there's a few things. I mean, usually there's, I'd say, about 1 item every day that everybody needs to know.
Yeah. Well, not that Hello Dolly.
But
Carol Channing. What's the Carol Channing? Tell everybody what the front page of the paper is going to be in New York tomorrow.
Okay.
Listen to this one, folks. Now, you wonder why I'm telling you what I'm telling you now.
There's a front page of the New York Post.
That says, Hell No Dolly.
Yes.
Because Dolly, who is Carol Channing, Broadway star, exceptional actress, wonderful comedian who has made us happy, at least. If we never knew this, I'd be a lot happier. Her husband didn't give her sex for 40 years.
Right? Ever seen a grown man naked?
I don't think so. Only backstage during La Cage. But there's been nothing about her. Why are we talking about Carol Channing's sex life?
Why
would that be a front page story?
Well, I know the New York Post has a tendency to be on the bit tabloid.
Well, how about Rupert Murdoch? I mean, when's the last time he had sex? Why don't they talk about that? He's the guy who owns the paper. Put him on the front page with his weenie. What about that? You know, is that, would he like that? You know what I would like? I would like to have me on the front page of the paper, casting the first stone. It's incredible, isn't it? No more Seinfeld. They have to talk about something. There's no more Seinfeld. So what's this, why Carol Channing's sex life? I mean, ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to the radio. Test. Wait. This is Joey Reynolds live all across the world on the internet, on the satellite system, on in New York City, and a bunch of other places testing. Do you need to know that Carol Channing only had sex twice in the last 40 years? Is this what your life's all about?
Yes.
Peter says it's twice more than me.
Which paper am I quoting?
The New York Post.
I think because people buy it.
The front page of the paper. Now, you don't think Regis is going to talk about that tomorrow morning? Regis and Kathy Lee, they're going to sit there and look at like a yellow journalism. It's not even that. I mean, they're going to
like it, though. I mean, people like
Carol Channing
like
sex,
though?
She's 70-some years old.
They love stories like that.
What? How many?
Me, personally, I can't stand it. But, I mean, a lot of people...
And they have him out to be...
People love gossip. Gossip sells.
That's true.
Gossip sells. It's the truth.
All right, we're going to take a break. Jim.
I got to go back to my
job. Yeah, I know. You got to get out of here. We got to bring the next guest
out. I'm going to get in trouble.
Why? What'd you do wrong? You didn't do nothing wrong.
Don't worry about it.
Have some of my cheesecake. Do you like my cheesecake?
Yeah.
We're selling it now.
It's very good.
We got it on the marketplace. I'm going to give you a phone number. If you want it, you got to pay now.
No more sales. Hey, he's going to charge me.
No more Mr. Nice Guy. Right. Bob Grant left me a note on my desk today, you know, New York talk show host. He says the only perk he gets out of this job is a cheesecake. It was his birthday last week. 50 years, I guess, in radio. He celebrated 50 years. So he's happens to be a very nice man and a funny guy. And he left me a note, but he doesn't mean-spirited show. So that's his act.
I'm a Bob Grant fan.
They asked me to not bring my cheesecake into him because it makes him too happy for on the air. Can you believe that? I mean, of all things, right? Please don't bring that in there now because Bob's on a roll. Now, here, I'm going to give you the telephone number, and then we'll take a break here. Our telephone number for the cheesecake from Joey Reynolds Company is 888-268-9555. You can call now. They got the tape on there, but the operators are on duty in the daytime, and they'll send it out to you, and you'll have it within a week. It's $35. So they make about $3 on the cake, folks. Don't get excited. 888-268-9555.